All right, we're here today in our training lab to discuss sump pumps and their importance in your home. Sump pumps are very important to the homes, especially in the Midwest. They literally reroute groundwater that can come into your home, into your basement, causing flooding. So they definitely assist and help in keeping your basement clean and dry. This is basically an above ground version of what a sump pump would look like inside of your home. This is the basin. This will be underground when you're going to look for your sump pump pit. This is a typical sump pump that you would see inside of the pit. This one in particular is a third horsepower, but they come in half horsepower. This is the actual sump pump itself. This is where the discharge line would be coming up, which is represented here. This is a float switch. This is what actually engages the pump to turn on. With this float, as the water rises in the pit, this float will come up with the rise of the water and engage itself. That's what tells the pump to turn on. If for some reason that float is obstructed or there's leaves or debris or anything making it so that that float does not do its job, your sump pump will not kick on, which can cause flooding, excess water damaging in your basement. This pipe right here would represent a drain tile, which is put outside of the home, outside of the foundation, comes into the sump pump pit or basin. There's a discharge pipe. That is what's connected to the sump pump. That will run up the foundation wall and then outside of the home. Ensure that you have a check valve, which is shown right here. A check valve is a one-way valve. It allows water to go one direction and not go back into the pit. If for some reason your check valve is faulty or malfunctioning, your sump pump will continuously run, which is really, really hard on your sump pump. What you should see when you first approach a sump pump pit is a pipe sticking out of it and hopefully a cover. The cover is very important on a sump pump pit for two reasons. Number one, if you have small animals, children, they can easily fall into the pit. Typically, sump pump basins are around 24 inches to 36 inches deep. Not good for small children or animals to fall into there. The second thing is to keep debris out of the pit. Sump pumps have a very small opening in which they take the water in and expel the water out of the home. Any debris that could fall in there could potentially clog the sump pump, causing it to overheat and malfunction. So a water alarm is placed somewhere near the sump pump. What that does is if your sump pump for some reason malfunctions or your pit overflows with water, a water alarm will detect that water and make a really, really loud noise, almost like a smoke detector, alerting you that there's water above your sump pump. Sump pumps do need power to operate. You do have to plug the sump pump into a power source. I would absolutely recommend to have a battery backup system with a maintenance-free battery on any home that has a sump pump or needs a sump pump. It's that extra bit of security, especially in the Midwest where we lose power quite often, that we don't have to really worry that our sump pump isn't working. Sump pumps are typically found at the lowest level of the home. That's where all your water, groundwater is going to collect, and that's where your water is gonna go. So sump pumps are found in the basement. If you live in a slab home, then they're on that level. Where your house is, you're at the top of a hill, or you're in an incline, does affect where your sump pump will be placed. It also affects how much your sump pump will work. Water always flows downhill. That's the way the water works. So there could be cases that you would want to make sure that your sump pump isn't working on overdrive. So sizing the pump for your home is definitely a necessity as well. The type of water that enters the sump pump is groundwater, which is typically rainwater or water that we just find normally coming up through the ground. It in no way is gray water or dirty water or water that may come from a faucet or sink or anything like that. It may smell old or kind of just stale watery, but it should never smell or have a sewer smell or anything like that. If you don't have a sump pump in your home and you do notice excess groundwater coming up from the foundation, foundation floor or foundation walls, it's definitely time to call a service professional and make sure that we locate the best area for where a sump pump should be installed to alleviate that problem.